Think you can hear me this morning? There we go. Okay. All right. We're ready. Good morning. Welcome to the Salem UMC live stream. We're so glad you joined us. There from your comfortable couch or chair at home, here for your viewing pleasure is your live stream service coming at you. To get started, just a few announcements for you, just to keep you up to date on things going on with the church. As things are starting to get opened back up in our state, the staff is in extreme prayerful consideration in regards to what our individual church, Salem UMC, is doing. And we're working with the conference to make sure that we as a church are making the best decision we possibly can for the safety of all of our members and congregants and staff and little ones and big ones and everyone in between. So we're prayerfully considering that and working with our conference to make sure we make the best decision. And then also please be aware, as things are changing in regards to your local church here at Salem UMC, you are going to be notified about it. We're going to keep you in the loop. We're going to let you know what the talks are and what's going on so you can be just as informed as we are about things going on here at the church. So be looking for that information as it comes your way. And until you get that notification, just a reminder that we are still going to continue to do the virtual stream services. So stay home right now. Enjoy the virtual worship service in your PJs, sipping on your cup of joe and eating your pancakes with us as we go through some worship time with our Lord and Savior, and invite you to join us for that. Just another reminder also that the church is still accepting donations through the post office for a check if you want to write a personal check to us. We check the mail every day right about the time it runs to make sure we get that taken care of as quickly as possible. Or online on our website or through the Tithely app. All those are avenues for continuing to support your church and the live stream you're seeing and everything else that your church is involved in. So prayerfully consider doing that as well. And without any further ado or announcements, I think we should get this service started. So join me in prayer, please. Heavenly Father, we pause this morning from going back to work and being at work and being quarantined and AMI schoolwork and all the other things and stressors that life has thrown at us to just be in your presence for a little while this morning, Lord. I pray that as we sit and we hear the service and we participate in the service, that you fill our hearts and you fill our lives with the Holy Spirit and allow us to feel him moving in us and through us during this time together. Lord, I pray that you hear our praise and you hear our worship and it is pleasing unto you. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Well, good morning. I would say if you're at home, you can stand and you can sing in front of that TV screen, and you can sway, whatever you want to do as we sing this morning. We're going to do one that you should know, Lord, Reign in Me.
Over all the earth you reign on high, every mountain stream, every sunset sky, you're my one request, Lord, my only aim is that you reign in me again. Lord,
sorry, technical difficulties. Welcome to live streaming. The screen just went blank, so sorry about that. Let's try it again. From the top. Give me just a minute. We went to the end. Oh.
Over all the earth you reign on high, every mountain stream, every sunset sky, but my one request, that you reign in me again. Lord, reign in me, reign in your power over all the earth. In my darkest hour, you are the Lord of all my am. So won't you reign in me again? that you reign in me again. Lord, reign in me, reign in your power over all the. In my darkest hour, you are the Lord over all I am. So won't you reign in me again. Lord, reign in me, reign in your power over all my dreams. Now my darkest hour, you are the Lord of all I am. So won't you reign in me again. Won't you reign in me again. Won't you reign in me again.
This one should be a familiar one. All right. Okay, now I got to tell you, we're going to sing all three verses. We'll sing the first two, and on the third verse, we're going to change keys. So just be prepared.
Okay, good morning again. Just real quick, we've had several people post on our live feed that they're having difficulties with the video not loading for them. Facebook, we've heard from our tech guru, Mr. Ruben Canada, who is all things on the ball of this. He said that Facebook released an app update this weekend. So if you're having trouble hearing or seeing our live stream, make sure your Facebook app is updated. So go to your Play Store or your iTunes Store and make sure that your app is updated. And once it loads update, then reopen your app and you should be able to see the live stream just fine. So make sure you do that and then jump on the comments and say hi and let us know you're here. Place your joys and concerns in those comments and let us know what's going on in your life, things you're excited about, things you want prayer for, anything like that. Place in those comments, but at this time,
a helpful thing.
Okay, if you see someone on the stream, Salem people, that is having issues, shoot them a message and kind of help them out with that, okay? We're trying to get to as many as we can, but there are a lot of people on there, so do your best to help each other out. Come together as one body of Christ, which is what we're called to do, and we're going to make sure that everyone can enjoy this stream together as quick as we possibly can. But at this time, Brother Justin, you want to come up and do some joys and concerns for us?
Yes, sir.
what did you say, real live or real life? This is real life. Just listing and looking through some of the prayer concerns that have been lifted over the last few Sundays in the life of our church and community. First, I want to give thanks to all who were a part of beginning our miracles in May. I know Miss Rachel has talked about the God sightings and God winks that we all see and experience and share in the good and great ways that God is at work in our lives, even in the midst of these times. I'm thankful as well for everybody who was a part of the beginnings of this great month of miracles and a month of prayer in our community in Saline County. In beginning, our church was the first on May 1st to kick off the series of daily prayers throughout this month, as we will be praying every day for our community, for our country, and for our world, and keeping prayer vigils with churches throughout Independence County. As part of all that is happening in the month of May, and specifically focusing on prayer, this Thursday, the first Thursday in May, is as always the National Day of Prayer. And so there will be a service held downtown in Benton, and it'll be broadcast. I got up here without writing down the FM station number, so don't hold me to it. It was like 87.5 maybe, but we'll post some comments later to clarify that. And there will be a half dozen pastors or so in our community sharing on Thursday night from the broadcast downtown. There will be more information about if you want to come and park downtown and roll your windows down or drive by and kind of have a prayer parade to be a part of that for the National Day of Prayer. I hope perhaps too you've taken an opportunity to visit our prayer wall. Mayor Farmer has been in communication with our Ministerial Alliance for really from the beginning, and during his time at home of self-quarantine, he and his son had the vision of having a prayer wall, and hope you might have visited there, taken a small cloth or a piece of paper to mark and share a prayer at our community prayer wall. But as we look to the life of our church, I know we continue to want to be in prayer for many, and especially those older adults in our church who may be at risk. We think about many of our older adults who have not been able to be out or a limited number of visits or those who can't have visits at all. I want to lift up our friend Mayor. I want to lift up our friend Melvin Sossman at the Manor on Boone Road. And if you don't have Melvin's cell number or address to send him a card, just contact us, or we'll be sure to post some contact information for you. At this time, he's not able to have visitors to see him, and so we want to call him and encourage him, do everything we can to keep his spirits up at this time. We also want to be praying for one of our seniors in particular who was scheduled to have surgery this week on one of her knees, our athlete, Miss Adriana Baber. And so prayers for her, as well as Ruth Smith and others in the life of our church. As always, we continue to pray for frontline and essential workers, for healthcare responders, for our government and for our country and our world. But let us also this day, in the midst of all the concerns that we share, let us lift up our joys and celebrations with each other. You'll see that there are a number of birthdays and some anniversaries that we celebrate this week. Troyce and Leanne Hamilton celebrate an anniversary on May 6th. I see that Holly Harper has a birthday on the 5th. Casey Younce and Quinn Rousey has a birthday on May the 8th. So let's sing our happy birthdays and anniversaries.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you. Happy anniversary. Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary, God bless you. Happy anniversary to you.
And let us come to rest as we think of many of these in our prayers, also as we think of our graduating seniors. Let us come to rest as Doug leads us in a time of reflection and prayer this morning. Lord, you reign in our hearts and in our lives, and we search and seek your will and your way. We hope this month in May, as we pray for our communities and our country and the world, this day, even as we pray for our graduating seniors, we hope, God, just to see you at work in our lives and in our neighbors. To see miracles even taking place around us each day. And Lord, we give ourselves to you. In times of trouble, we lean on you. And in times of joy, we celebrate with you. And in this time and in this moment, in this hour, we pray to you, Lord, and we give ourselves to you. As we pray the prayer, Lord Jesus, which you teach your followers to live. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning, kids. How are we doing today? I have brought my teddy bear with me today, and I have my pillow. I am so excited for my Sunday afternoon nap. How many of y'all take a Sunday afternoon nap? Several hands in here are raising up, guys. We love our Sunday afternoon naps in our house. You just get to, oh, it's just a perfect day to lay down and to rest, and you snuggle up and just, oh, I could fall asleep right now thinking about it. Sleep and resting is such a big deal. Our bodies are created that when we rest, you get more energy, you rejuvenate, your body actually gets better of whatever's going on. And that's kind of a big deal. So how many of y'all take naps every day? Or maybe even just like mom says, okay, I want you to go lay down and just rest for a little bit. You don't have to go to sleep. Maybe you can sit down and rest and read a book and you lay back. That's another good thing I like to do on Saturdays. You get all comfy and you lay back and you get that good book out and you're just reading and you just relax and rest. Rest is so, so important. After a long day of work on the computer, and then maybe you get a chance to go outside and play basketball, or like in our house right now, we're working on all kinds of projects. And so we're in the backyard working on trees and patios, and there's so much stuff going on. When you finally get to sit down and just rest, it's so nice. Well, God also is like that too. He is there for us to just rest and rejuvenate and get more energy from Him. Now, it's not necessarily the energy that you get after you take your nap and you jump up and you're ready to run and have so much fun and jump rope and who knows, all those fun things that you can do as a kid, but it's the energy that you can get to keep going and to be able to have the energy and the things to do with everything going on in the world. You have that strength to keep going and to know that God is good and He's taking care of us. So tonight, or this afternoon, if you take your nap, or maybe you're just laying down to relax or to rest, I want you to think about that God is there for us to rest in Him. He gives us that energy that we need. Just like whenever you wake up from that nap, you know what I'm talking about, or you wake up in the morning, that good energy to be able to get up and keep going. That's what we can also get from God, the energy to just keep going and keep doing all the good things for Him to help spread His love and spread His light. So take a tip from me, lay down on Sunday afternoon, take a rest, snuggle up with your favorite stuffed animal or your pillow or your teddy bear or whatever it is, and rest. Say a prayer to God and say, thank you, God, so much for being our rest and our relaxation and giving us the energy that we need to keep going every day for you. So let's pray real quick, guys. Dear Lord, thank you so much for this day, and I thank you for our entire church family. Thank you for the fact that you give us those times to rest, Lord, because our body needs it. It needs it to repair itself and to have more energy, but Lord, our soul also needs that rest so that we can then continue to do your work and to spread your love throughout this world. Help us this week as we do that, and keep us safe. We pray all this in your name. Amen. All right, kiddos, make sure that you listen to your parents, wash your hands, get some rest this week, and remember that we love you and that God loves you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Our scripture lesson this morning comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 28. It says, "Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Now, I don't have much of a shoe game. My kicks aren't too legit, but I am capable, I'm proud to say, of tying the double knot. I'm rocking my double knot today, my swoop and my loop and, you know, my double knot to keep them from being a trip hazard. And you say, what does that have to do with anything? It's simply this. As I was thinking about our seniors, especially this weekend and this morning, I was thinking about all of the things that they have done, all of the places that they have been. I know it sounds like a Dr. Seuss story, and yet too, all of the places they're going to go and all of the things they're going to do. As part of that, I was thinking too about all the little things along the way, even as far back as kindergarten. And the simple yet important lessons that are learned, including tying your shoes. It was one of those things that I had trouble getting just right when I was a kid. It seemed like my laces were coming undone all of the time. I remember even as far back as childhood, a particular memory that I have of a friend, and it was his birthday, and he got a brand new bike for his birthday, and he was cool enough to let us all take turns riding it around the circle drive way at his parents' house. And I remember when it got to be my turn, and I was so excited when my friend Bob Young, rest in peace, let me ride the bike around this driveway. And I, you know, as kids do, we're kind of cheering each other on, sort of doing our own version of NASCAR, you know, or maybe the 24 hours a day, switching out bike riders. And sadly, when it was my turn to ride my friend Bob's bike, when I was pedaling with all fury around and around his driveway, the laces got caught around the pedals and the gears. And I didn't realize it was happening, though. I'm sure the cheering was probably turning towards panic. And before I knew it, I was locked up and on the pavement and had bent the handlebars and dinged up his brand new birthday bike. So I am proud again to say that I've got my laces safely double swooped today. There are all kinds of lessons that we learn along the way. There are so many things that we need to know, all kinds of information that's passed to us and through us with teachers and family and friends and classmates and communities along our way, both in the classrooms and in our homes, in ball fields, and in band rooms, in trips, in activities, so many things that happen. They tell us that on average, our graduating seniors in grades 1 through 12 should have spent 2,160 days in education. 2,100, now that's classroom days, school days, whether at home or on campus of a public or private school, 2,160 days of education. That's a lot of advice, some of it well received, some of it solicited, and some not. In the midst of all of that we have been given, in all that we have received, in all that we have practiced and experienced, and that we have accepted and rejected, that we have made our own way of tying our shoes even, whether the bunny went around the tree or through the hole, however it was you were taught. Even crisscross applesauce, I still haven't quite managed that. I could never be a yogurt teacher or a regular teacher because I'm not good at crisscross applesauce. I saw, though, that So many of us are still wanting to give advice. I know the president is going to be speaking to the graduates of West Point, I think, so I was told. At least that was his desire to convene them. So many people in business and entertainment and so forth that will be speaking at graduations here and there from one side of the country to the other. So many family members, even maybe, that will offer us advice. And I saw sort of a top 10 list of advice for graduating seniors. On that list were words such as, it's important to keep counsel. And really, that's a part of what I want to say to you today, how important it is to keep counsel. That is to be in conversation with God and with other people, not to go it alone. How important it is to have and to offer respect to all the people around us. How important it is to have a team or co-workers, if you will, along the way. To be patient on the list was number 7. And number 6 was to always be making more connections. Number 5 was to learn every day. I can tell you that that's a piece of advice and consent that I continue to try to experience and can say in many ways I've probably learned a lot in the last several weeks and even today. To keep moving forward was number 4. To keep moving forward. Number 3 was never to hide your mistakes. That's a good piece of advice. Mistakes aren't something that we should be in denial about. But again, back to number 4, to keep moving forward. And to number 5, to learn every day. Those things are connected. Moving forward, making mistakes, and learning. The top 2, though, were, at least from the word searching of people's graduation speeches, were to be open to change and to be true to yourself. The truth is, graduates, we are very proud of all that you have done. And maybe more importantly, we are proud of the person that you are. Not just in the things that you do. I can't go into these Zeusisms, but in the person that you are. And so today we do celebrate you this Sunday morning as we're here to worship in spirit and in truth together, to celebrate together. We celebrate who you are. We give thanks for your life in our midst, your church family and our community. And in this moment too, though, as we celebrate for you and as we celebrate with you, we also want to lift up the people who are a part of your journey. To say simply this, as proud of as we are of you and all that you've done, know that you didn't get here alone. You had to step on the shoulders of some giants. I hope I have a slide, maybe. And it may seem out of place or time to some of you, but I share that simply to say this. Even the Lone Ranger didn't go it alone. Even the Lone Ranger didn't go it alone. In fact, if you have ever, you know, watched the old TV shows or seen the remake movie, I mean, Tonto is the brains of the outfit. The Lone Ranger doesn't go it alone, and neither do you. Your families, your parents and grandparents, your cousins and aunts and uncles have been a part of your journey since you were in the water of a womb. Someone has been praying over you and for you all the days of your life, and always will all the days of their life. And while today you maybe aren't having your favorite orange Jell-O salad at grandma's house or some things of that nature, know that your grandma or pops, your nini and granddad, even though maybe they're not in your living room this day, they will be in your heart forever. Forever. That all the days of their life on this earth, and even in the life to come, the life beyond their death, they will pray for you and with you and over you. know that your friends and church family, and we joke about this sometimes, Miss Rachel and Russell say, you know, we have you from birth to 18, although I'm afraid it goes long beyond that. In fact, one of Miss Carol's little teenage youth groupers happens to be sitting on pew number 2 this very morning, and that's Miss Rachel Powell and Miss Jenna Jones. And I can tell you that Miss Carol hasn't given up on these girls yet. Amen? And then lastly, I want to say this, seniors, as much as we celebrate you, as much as we are so proud of you and for you, and we are so thankful for all of those who are a part of your journey, of your family and your friends, the people who you have leaned on in times of trouble and need, the people who have been there to get you from ball practice and band practice, the people who are a part of your journey. And as a last thought, seniors, as surely as you don't need to have anyone to tell you how to loop it or swoop it anymore, you know, it starts pretty early, I'm learning, with preteens. I know, I can do it. As surely as you know and you can do it, I want to encourage you in this, that now it's so important for you as you journey from here and there and everywhere to college or career and in military service, whatever that may be, how important it is for you to remember that you can lean on God and other people, that the Lord will be here to lift you up and to reign in you, that others will be here for you to lean on them. How important it is for you, my friends, to carry the burdens of others. The Lord Jesus will always be there, as He promised us in His Word. He says, "Come to me, all you who are weary and heavy burdened, and I will give you rest." I'm sure you're tired, seniors, and find your rest in these days and weeks. But always be ready now, you, to be the helping hand. You to be the guiding hands that show somebody else how to get it together. You to be the one to reach down to those who are weaker, alone, or afraid. How important it is for you to help carry the burdens of your neighbors, of your friends, of your classmates and co-workers. For the Bible says that in this way, that is, in the helping of others, you will fulfill the law of Christ. Amen? God be with you this day and every day and always. We celebrate you this day. We will be excited at the tail end of our service. Really, the high point is coming. We have a super awesome slideshow with our seniors and some pictures of their journey and the awesome piece of music, Lean on Me, as we celebrate you, as we know about all those who you've leaned on along the way, the Lord and the people in your life and that you love. God bless you, our seniors. Everywhere you go and everything you do, you awesome you. Amen, amen, and amen.
Sometimes in your life, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are strong, we all know there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Doug, for playing along with the slideshow. That was fantastic. Thank you, Miss Rachel, for putting that together. It was a beautiful slideshow. Wonderfully done. So seniors, we love you. We're so proud of you. We can't wait to see what the future holds for you and your lives. Go out there and make us proud. We're so excited. And as we say at the end of every single youth meeting, we pray that you are a bright light and that the love of Christ shines through you in everywhere you go and every person you meet. I just remember that that please make sure that you join us next week. Same Facebook time, same Facebook channel, right from the comfort of your home. We'll be doing this again next week. So same time, same place, same channel. We'll be here next week. But I pray that all of you have a wonderful week. I pray that all of you are able to get some rest this week, that you share in one another's burdens, and you just be there for your other church people as they need you. Be blessed. Amen.